Buckle up, science enthusiasts. We're about to embark on a wild safari into the jungle's happy hour.
Where fruits ferment, elephants dance, and nature brews its own wine.
Ready for a tipsy adventure? Today, we'll unravel the science of yeast, fermentation, and intoxication. So get ready for a journey through fermentation, seed dispersal, and the ecological dance of life. By the end of this video, you will even learn how to brew your own animal juice at home, too. So, have you ever wondered how a fruit can become a party drink for animals? It's all about fermentation. Basically, this is a process where tiny microorganisms like yeast feast on the sugars in fruits. They convert them into alcohol and carbon dioxide.
Most people don't know this, but some wild fruits rich in sugars naturally produce more alcohol during fermentation. It's nature's way of brewing. In the wild, fruits like the marula and palm fruit undergo a natural transformation. As they overripen, yeast present on their skins begins to ferment the sugars, turning them into alcohol.
The marula fruit, native to southern Africa, is rich in vitamin C and known for its sweet and tangy taste.
But what makes it truly unique is its high sugar content, which leads to natural fermentation.
This basically means when ripe, it naturally ferments, creating alcohol. The alcohol in these wild fruits is called ethanol.
It's the same type of alcohol found in your favorite beverages. Most people don't know this, but marula fruit is not just a treat for the taste buds. It also plays a vital role in local ecosystems. When the marula fruit falls to the ground, it starts to ferment.
The sugars in the fruit are converted into alcohol by natural yeasts present in the environment. In a nutshell, yeast cells feast on these sugars, converting them into alcohol and carbon dioxide, creating a unique aroma and taste.
Oh, and here is a cool fun fact.
Did you know that yeast has been used in fermentation for over 5,000 years? This makes it one of humanity's oldest biotechnological processes.
The process in which yeasts convert sugars into alcohol. Fermentation. It's not just for bread and beer. In the wild, fruits like the marula undergo a magical transformation, thanks to yeast. But what exactly is yeast?
You can think of yeast as a microscopic fungus, a tiny chef that turns sugar into alcohol and carbon dioxide. Imagine billions of these chefs cooking up a storm inside a fruit. Once the fermentation process starts, the enzymes in yeast break down sugar into ethanol and CO2. It's like a chemical dance party where sugar molecules waltz into alcohol. Talk about a sweet transformation.
Here's another fun fact for you. Marula trees are dioecious, meaning they have separate male and female plants. It seems even trees might be dealing with their own relationship drama.
So what is the point of all this information? Well, we just simply wanted to share the fact that nature has its way of creating balance and harmony.
Okay, now last but not least, do you want to join the jungle party? Here's your DIY guide to brewing your own animal juice.
Step 1. Choose fresh, ripe fruit like grapes or berries. Step 2. Crush the fruit to release the juices and add sugar if needed. Next, step 3. Add yeast and allow it to ferment in a clean container covered with a cloth. Step 4. After a week, strain the liquid and transfer it to a bottle. And step 5. Enjoy your homemade wine responsibly.
So to recap, choose your fruit, crush it, not your fingers. Add some party-loving yeast and let the magic happen. And cheers to homemade happiness.
Until next time. Back it up and you drop it down low. When you pick it up, girl, I'm ready to blow. I'ma stack it up and I'm spending it all. When I throw it up, start twerking like Miley. Twerking like